Hi everyone, it's Friday the 22nd of January and it's 10 to 8 in the evening. Now, this video is going to be different from the normal random crap that I usually do because I'm going to be talking paranormal stuff. Ghosts and, you know, weird happenings and all that stuff. Now, before I get into that, I just want to say I'm not doing this video to try and turn those who don't believe into believers. I fully respect those that don't believe in that sort of stuff. I personally do from my own experiences. There's actually one that sticks into my mind that really turned me into a believer myself, because I used to be skeptical as anything when I was younger, and still I start and still until I had my own experiences. That said, this all started with a couple of incidents recently, actually, this week. Like, both happened this week. But before I get to that, I'm going to rewind and go to the beginning of when I pretty much moved into this flat and just go over a few things I've noticed, you know, at night, things I've heard, things I've seen, things I can't actually explain how it's happened, you know, that sort of thing. So one of the biggest things that actually sticks in my mind was, I don't know, the first year, maybe the second year, actually I think it was like the second or third year I'd lived in this flat. It was a hot summer's night, so I've got the windows open, zero breeze, perfectly still night, bedroom door wide open, as far open as it would go, and the bottom of the door actually scrubbed on the carpet. You'd get the door sort of partway closed and it'll start to really scrub, so it's a bit of a bugger to shut. And I'm lying there, and this was sort of 2 to 2:30 in the morning, and all of a sudden that door slammed shut and scared the bloody crap out of me. Now, I tried to replicate the force that slammed shut with the next morning, and I couldn't do it. I could not get it to slam like it did that night. Keeping in mind, it scrubbed like hell on the carpet, because I think the floor is actually uneven in there. This is an old building, and that's a concrete floor, so it might have a few, you know, humps and bumps in it. Or it could have just been the carpet I had down there, and that was crap. It was pink at the time, and it was free, so, you know, I just made do with what I could get hold of. Anyway, the way that slammed shut, I didn't even hear it scrub on the carpet. It did it with that much force. I actually thought it was going to go through the door frame. It did it with that much force. So I cannot explain it. Like I said, there's no wind, no breeze. Even if there was a breeze, it wouldn't have been strong enough to do what that did. Meanwhile, I was meowing. So I have no idea. There's been lots of other tiny little things I've noticed, and, you know, little sounds of things moving in the bedroom at night. But you know, it could have been anything. Who knows? Could have just been a bit of furniture creaking as things, you know, the atmosphere changed, I don't know. Those little sounds I heard could be fully explainable, but to me, that door, it can't. There was just, there was nothing in that room that could have slammed it shut like that. And I've noticed other little things, like sometimes I've woken up in the mornings and I've got an illuminated keyboard here, and I've found that lit up. The only way you can trigger that is if you press a button. For some reason, it will still light up even if the PC is turned off. Any key, it doesn't matter what key, the lights will come on when the PC is turned off. Yeah, I've found that a number of times. Same with my mouse here, let me see, it's got that flashing symbol on it. I've come through in the mornings and found that flashing again. That will trigger if you press the buttons. So, And I'm not sure I can blame Nemo because he's getting really, really bad on his legs because he's getting old, bless him. And to be honest, he's not been up on this desk since the last time he fell out of that lounge window or whatever window it was he fell out of last time. So, yeah, he doesn't jump up on things like he used to, especially something this high. It could be him. I don't know, but to be honest, the only time I've actually known him to get up here is when I've been sitting here. If I'm not here, he doesn't get up here. So, he might have, he might not have, I don't know. Again, that could just be a simple explanation of Nemo actually has gotten up here. I don't know. I personally don't think he has. What else? I actually came home one evening, not long after my best friend's funeral, and found a torch lying in the middle of the bedroom floor, turned on. And the other coincidental thing that day was, because I was down at Mum's, I think it might have been the day of the funeral actually, and I was just thinking to myself, you know, if you're there, Rick, and you're all right, give me a sign. And I come home to find a torch turned on in the middle of my floor. And it was a click button torch. It wasn't no soft touch. It was an actual click switch torch. And in the middle of the floor was not where I left it either. So, make of that what you will. Now, there's probably other things that I've seen over the years I can't think of at the minute. I'm just remembering, you know, the bigger things. But recently, I can't remember if it was Monday or Tuesday this week, it was not far after 2 o'clock. I will say that most of these incidents have happened after 2 o'clock in the morning. But this one was four extremely loud bangs. What I think was the pipework that runs along the wall in my bedroom, where my flashing lights and everything are, my light bars, police light bars are, for the central heating. Now, I've had people say it could be an airlock or something like that, but these were four consecutive bangs, extremely loud. Now, I've lived in places with gas central heating all my life. I'm used to the airlocks that can get in there. I know what they sound like. I know what the knocks and bangs and whatnot some heating systems can make. In fact, Mum's is a very noisy system. Mine's pretty quiet here. In fact, it's never made any knocks or bangs or anything like that. Apart from the bathroom radiator, that makes a bit of a bubbly noise. But that's always done that despite me bleeding it, so. But, yeah, I'm not convinced, just from how loud it was, and, you know, the four were in time, four knock bangs in time, and to me, it sounded like someone had got a pipe wrench or a spanner or something metallic like that, heavy, and was banging on the pipes with it as hard as they could. And to top it off, I've actually noticed that two of my light bars have actually moved because they're not how I put them. And there's no way Nemo can get up there to do it. No way. But I didn't think nothing of it. Next night, nothing. I slept fine. Wednesday night, however, I'm sitting in here. 4 minutes past two exactly, three bangs were heard again on that pipework. And I had headphones on and I heard that clear as day over my headphones. That's how loud it was. So, I'm not convinced it's the heating. I would have thought if it was the heating, actually I hadn't had the heating on for over 24 hours that day. I haven't got the heating on now. I still haven't turned it on actually since Tuesday. It's actually quite cosy up here at the minute, to be honest. But, yeah, anyway. Yeah, it's just how loud they were. In fact, it sounded like metal on metal. I'm just not convinced it was the heating. Oh, that's what I was going to say. I would have thought if it was an airlock in the heating, it would be at random points throughout the whole day. Not twice in 1 week at roughly the same time of night. I don't think it was exact, but I know it wasn't far off. 5 minutes difference, maybe, something like that. I know the first time I was actually trying to get to sleep. I didn't wake up and then was going back to sleep. I was actually trying to get to sleep the first time. Yeah. I don't know. But I put a couple of statuses up about it on Facebook. Each time it happened, I put a status up. And last night, a friend of mine on Facebook also collects barricade lights and whatnot, and we've helped each other out. He sent me stuff, and I've sent him a couple of bits and whatnot. Anyway, he's also a subscriber to the channel. He messaged me saying that in one of my videos, he'd seen what looked like little orbs or lights, as he first described them. And I have to admit, at first I was like, that's probably a bit dust, you know, a bit of reflecting light or something. But he went to the video, and I will link it down below so you can see, and I'll give the list of timestamps as well so you can skip ahead to those, and copy and paste them or whatever, or open it in a new link, new tab. You will need it on full screen though to see it properly. But I was looking through them this morning, and I didn't get all the way through, and he is absolutely right. And I showed Mum as well. And she's convinced that these were actual orbs. Now, you'll see in the video, it's an unboxing video I did with a bunch of barricade lights I'd purchased on eBay. It was a two-parter, and it's in part two. Like I said, I'm going to link it down below anyway. And every time, well, I say every time, most of the time when you see it, it's down my left side. In fact, one of them got pretty close to the camera. Now, some people might say it's just flakes of dust, but as I was talking with Mum, she said it doesn't look anything like how dust would look on a camera. You know, dust floats quite, gracefully. You know? And the first one you actually see literally goes in a straight line right across the camera. Probably about there on me in camera shot, because obviously I had the camera pointed at the table I was working on mostly instead of my face, so you could only see my shoulders. And yeah, that just went in a dead straight line. But that to me is not behavior of a speck of dust. And it just looked like it was too controlled, you know. Didn't look like a random floating bit of dust. We've all seen dust in sunlight. We all know what it looks like. It looked nothing like that. And then there was others. There was one that literally went down the side of my arm. You see them go down the side. You see them go straight up the screen as well. And I'm pretty certain dust doesn't actually, you know, randomly float upwards. Maybe on a breeze or anything, but as that was recorded October of 2018, I was actually quite sweaty because I think that was quite a hot year, that one, if I remember rightly. We had quite a hot summer. And I actually state in the video that what you could actually see when I moved the camera to show you my face, you could see I was sweating like a pig. But yeah, there was a number of incidents. There was one there where there was like the only way I can describe it was like an explosion of orbs. There was just loads all over the screen. That could have been dust. I'm not entirely convinced, you know, that everything there was an orb, but that one, I don't know, to be honest. That one has me puzzled. I might go back and watch the video myself, just to see that bit again. But I never thought I'd actually catch anything like that on camera in my life. And it was unintentional. I can show you my computer. I do not have any editing software that could put anything like that into a video. So I have not touched the video. It's just exactly how I recorded it that day. Shoved it through Windows Movie Maker, as I do with my videos, and I still do it to this day. I just, you know, trim the beginning, trim the end, and because I believe I had this camera at the time. I believe I was using this camera. Actually, I'm sure I was using this camera. Actually, 2018. Yeah, I was using this camera. 100%. And it has like a little bit of the picture pauses at the beginning and the end, so I have to like trim those little bits off. And then I just put like an intro screen, an outro screen, you know, thanks for watching at the end. That is it, that's all I do. Don't often have to do any chopping and cutting in the middle unless I am like stopping and starting the video because I have to move things around or whatever. Most of the time, like I'm doing with this one, one-shot video. You know, I'm not pausing it, I'm not doing any retakes or anything. It's as is. I'll just go with it as is, do those two little trims, add on the title screen and the credit screen, click save and upload it to YouTube. That's all I do. I don't have any other, you know, movie editor on the computer. I never have. I wouldn't even know how to use it. So, to me, that confirms that either a spirit is attached to me, which I personally believe, because wherever I've lived, I've noticed a lot of weird things going on and strange noises and seeing things and just this flat. So I think whatever it is following me around, not connected to the building itself. I found it odd that throughout the whole video, like I said, most of the time it was literally at my side, as if whatever it was standing right beside me. And, there's a few other things that I want to go through. That bedroom, ever since I've lived here, has always been the coldest. I can guarantee if I now go in there right now, even though the bedroom window's shut and has been for the last 2 days, that room is going to feel colder than this one. In fact, if I had a digital thermometer, I could prove it, but I haven't got one at the minute. But I am toying with the idea of buying a few bits like that just so I can confirm that room is actually colder than any of the other rooms in the flat. Always has been. Mum actually asked when I filmed that video with all these orbs in if I actually felt anything at the time, and I was like, no. I didn't see anything, didn't notice anything, didn't hear anything. But yet, there they are. On camera. And I'm pretty certain, you know, how big those specks of dust, as some people will call them, are. You'd have noticed those with your eye. Especially as I'm one of those people that like to pay attention to detail and things. Silly little things like that would distract me, because my eyes would, like, get distracted by the bloody light. You know, because I keep seeing little reflections and things in my own eyeballs, and I look up. Oh no, it's just a light. I didn't ask for your opinion. Shut up. that's the other thing I've noticed as well. Especially when I had the Lego City up, I would notice that figures will randomly seem to change hairstyles, heads, hats, you know, headgear, and all of that. I'd go to a set that I've had perhaps stored in a box or something. I'm like, I didn't put them like that. And I used to joke, you know, that my figures come alive at night and they swap everything, because that's happened on a number of occasions. Maybe it's not. I've even had my neighbour below me complain about banging at night when I'm fast asleep in bed. It's not me, I'm asleep. Nemo's not heavy enough to do that banging. He said it's tools. It sounded like tools dropping on the floor. But I'm in bed, asleep. So, how? I don't know. I'm going to look into it more myself. I've actually got a friend on Facebook who's recently started doing all of this ghost hunt stuff, and he's done a few real ones himself. But I don't know how much, you know, simple gadgets like the EMF meters they use and the digital thermometers are and whatnot. You know, if they're going to be like stupidly expensive, then I may not bother. But, oh, that was another one I had happen. I woke up one night with the TV on. And it's only ever done it once. And it's not done it since. Now, some people might say, well, Nemo may have stood on the remote. The remote was not accessible at the time, and he wasn't even in the bedroom when I woke up. And I said, even if he was, the remote was pointing in the wrong direction for stars and wouldn't even work if he did stand on it. So, some people might say it'd be a bug or a fault with the electronics. Possible. But I would have thought if it was, it would have done it more than the once in the 2-3 years ago that it did it. Like I said, it's not done it since that one time. So, maybe it could have been just a freak glitch in the electronics. That's a perfect possibility. But I just think if it was, it would have done it a lot more regularly than just once in, like I said, the 2 or 3 years since it first happened. I think that is it. So, leave your comments down below. Do you believe in such things? Do you not believe? I'd also say go watch the video first before leaving a comment as well. So, give your opinion on what you see in that video. I'm interested. I'm up for a discussion about it, you know, with those that believe and those that don't believe. My stepdad doesn't believe. And the thing is, he says he's seen things like that and things like I've seen, but he said he still doesn't believe, which is, it's fair enough. Like I said at the beginning of the video, I'm not here to try and make people believe. It's your choice, you know. Some people really just don't like to believe in things unless they can physically see it. So that's fair enough. So the comment section is open for debate. So on that note, thanks a lot for watching, everyone. I hope you found the video interesting. Pardon me, and I'll talk to you again in the next one. Bye.